everybody, Donna Salazar for Spellbinders. Today I have a tutorial showing you how to make a garden fairy princess dress form. It's got a little stick in it so that you can put it in a potted plant. And I'm going to use my jumbo rose and art doll steel rule dies, as well as the art doll accessory set, which is an etched die set. And I'll also be using the stamps for the art doll accessory set that has a little crown in it, and that will go on top of the dress form. I'm going to show you a bunch of techniques that I use to make this cute little three-dimensional project. So the art doll accessories die set has wings in it, and there's two parts to it. There's the middle part and the outside part, and you're going to want two of each of those wings using both of the parts together. The stamp set has some crowns in it, and the die set has dies that go perfectly with the stamps. So you're going to cut out two of those, only one of them needs to be stamped, and then two of the bodies from the art doll set, and then three each of the jumbo rows, three of each size. Now I am inking the edge of the art doll bodies with mixed media inks, and this is the honey color. And this is the one that is pigment-based, and so it stays wet longer, and it blends really. It's kind of like a paint. It almost feels like a paint. It's really thick. And then these are the Mixed Media Inks Chalks in Petals, and these are great for stamping, and when you add those over the inks, then they blend really nicely. Then I'm going to use the same inks for the flowers around the edges of all of them. And then once I finish with the inks, then I add the chalks. And these are the same colors that I put on the body of the art doll. And the pink blends really nicely with the honey mixed media inks. And so I used those on all of those. Now for the wings, I used the honey mixed media inks first on the front of all of them. And then I added the mixed media inks in mossy. Now something that I didn't mention earlier when I was talking about die cutting these wings is that you could actually use the outside die all by itself and you'd have a solid wing, or you could use the outside die, die cut that, and then use the inside, that is the detail, on that and just emboss it. And so you'd have a solid wing with just the embossed detail of the wing on the inside. And now I'm using a darker green, it's called Verdigris, and they all mix and blend really well together. So I'm adding a stick to the inside of the art doll bodies, and I use Dodds Excel for that. And then I'm going to add a little bit of Girly Grunge Art Medium. It's a liquid adhesive that would work really well. And now I'm adding the stamped crown to the front and the blank crown to the back. And adhering them together will keep them on the body. Now I've got a lot of strips of Girly Grunge gauze, and I'm taking small strips and tying them to a long strip. And I'm just tying a whole bunch of knots, and then I'll just push them all together once I have a whole bunch of them tied. And then I'm just going to wrap them around the center of the body and then tie it at the back, and then push down both edges and then kind of trim off the excess, but we'll trim that up a little bit better afterward. Now I'm using the tool-in-one to cut all of the petals on all of the flowers that we die cut and inked. You're going to do the same thing for every one of the petals, both sizes. You can also shape the wings, but you don't have to. Now you're going to take your scissors and you're going to start in between two of the petals, cut through to the hole, and then a little bit past it. You want this to be able to slide across the body of the art doll.
So you're going to slide the first one on, add double-sided adhesive on top of the flower petal. Then you're going to take the next flower and you're going to slide it from the opposite side. So the opening will be on the right side of the body and then on the left side of the body. And now you're going to take the next flower and you're going to slide it from the left side. So the opening again is on the right side of the body. And I start with the larger petals for the bottom three, and then I'm going to add the smaller petals on top of that. And you can see it works out pretty easily. And it makes an adorable skirt. So this is the last one that I'm going to put the adhesive on top of the flower petal. And that's helping the layers to stay together as well. And then for the last one, I'm going to put the adhesive underneath the flower petal so there is an exposed adhesive on the top. So I actually moved the flower off, added the adhesive, and then put the flower back on. Then I fluffed up the skirt a little bit, just kind of lifted the petals. And now I'm going to trim off the excess gauze. So it almost looks like a little ballerina outfit. Then I soaked some lace in some Girly Grunge Art Medium and just laid it across the middle and let that dry and it'll stiffen the lace. I added some double-sided adhesive to the back of the body to adhere the wings. And then I added a little bit more on top of it to add the second layer of wings. And I call this a Garden Fairy Princess dress form because the dress looks like it's a flower and the wings look like they could be plant-based. So I'm just adding more adhesive for that second layer. And then I've got a bow that I tied from organza ribbon. And I added an adhesive dot and heated that. And it makes it like hot glue, but it's controlled in a little tiny spot. Then I added a little flower to the front. And this is a close-up of the back. And here's a couple close-ups of the dress form outside on our patio. All of my Spellbinders products can be found on the Spellbinders website.
Thanks so much for joining me, and I'll see you again next time. Bye.